Right. Now we will discuss about cervical plexus. Cervical plexus are formed by upper four cervical nerves. That means anterior primary rami of upper four cervical nerves. Let me draw those structures. C1, C2. Let me give little space. This is C1, C2, C3, C4, and we can draw C5 also, right? So these are the anterior primary rami of C1, C2, C3, C4, and C5. This is anterior primary rami of C1. This is anterior primary rami of C2. This is anterior primary rami of C3. This is anterior primary rami of C4. And this is anterior primary rami of C5. Actually, C5 we should not write, but it will give small contribution for the formation of phrenic nerve. That's what I have written over here. Clear? So, this is C1. Right? This C1 enters into the hypoglossal nerve. Right? And it supplies to these two muscles. This nerve is uniting or enters into hypoglossal nerve. So this is hypoglossal nerve. After entering into the hypoglossal nerve, it gives mainly three branches. What are those? One branch is descending down. This branch, what we are calling superior root of ansa cervicalis, otherwise we can call it as descendens hypoglossi. See, this is descendens hypoglossi. This C1 nerve, that means anterior primary rami of C1, giving one branch as descendens hypoglossi, and another branch is supplying to two muscles here. What are those? See here, this is thyrohyoid. Thyrohyoid. Then what is this? Geniohyoid. Geniohyoid. Thyrohyoid. Clear? So this is about C1, right? Now there will be formation of descendant cervices. There will be formation of descendant cervices or inferior root of ansa cervicalis. That will be formed by C2 and C3. These two will form descendants cervices, right? So this descendants hypoglossi and descendants cervices united and forms loop over the carotid sheath. What is this loop? This loop, what we are calling ansa cervicalis. This loop is ansa cervicalis. This ansa cervicalis supplies here superior belly of homohyoid, here inferior belly of homohyoid. Remember like this. This is supplying to the superior belly of homohyoid. This is supplying to the inferior belly of homohyoid. Superior belly of homohyoid, inferior belly of homohyoid. Then sternothyroid, sternohyoid. Sternothyroid and sternohyoid. These two branches are supplying to sternohyoid and sternothyroid. Through the loop, these are the muscles are supplying. Now we know how ansa cervicalis has been formed. Clear? Then there will be loop-like communication between C1 and C2. That means anterior primary rami of C1 and anterior primary rami of C2. Right? So this is loop-like communication. Clear? This loop-like communication will give some branches. What are those branches? One branch is communicating with the vagus nerve. So this is communicating branch to the vagus nerve. Right? Then it gives branches, or it supplies to the rectus capitis anterior and rectus capitis lateralis. Rectus capitis anterior and rectus capitis lateralis. Then It supplies longus capitis. Longus capitis. So loop formed in between C1 and C2 supplying communicating branch to the vagus nerve, nerve to rectus capitis anterior, nerve to rectus capitis lateralis and nerve to longus capitis. Then see, this is C2 and this is C3. In between C2 C3 also there will be loop like communication. Let me draw that loop like communication. Like this only, here also there is loop like communication. See, this is loop like communication between C2 and C3. Anterior primary rami of C2 will give branches to longus capitis and longus coli. Along with that, it will give one sensory nerve also. This C2. What is that nerve? Let me draw the sensory nerve with different color so that you can understand properly. So, what is this nerve? This is lesser occipital nerve. What is this nerve? This is lesser occipital nerve. Lesser occipital nerve. Then, here there is communication between C2 and C3. From this communication, there will be origin of two nerves. Those two nerves also sensory nerves only. What are those? This is great auricular. This is great auricular. And this is transverse cervical. This is transverse cervical and this is great auricular. From where? From the communicating loop between C2 and C3. Then see here, C3 is there and C4 is there. Fibers from C3 and fibers from C4 forms one nerve here. This nerve is supraclavicular nerve. What is it? This is supraclavicular nerve. This is supraclavicular nerve. Then fibers from C3, C4 and small contribution from C5 will forms another important nerve. What is this? C3, C4 and small contribution from C5. What is this nerve? Phrenic nerve. Phrenic nerve is arising from fibers from anterior primary rami of C3, C4 and C5. Then here we have to see branches from C3 and C4. Some branches supplying to longus coli and longus capitis. Along with that, C3 will give innervation to sternocleidomastoid. Okay, so here sternocleidomastoid. Then fibers from C3 and C4. These fibers are supplying to trapezius, scalenus medius, levator scapulae. Right? So trapezius, levator scapulae and scalenus medius. These muscles are supplied by C3 and C4. Clear? So, this is the cervical plexus. Here, how many sensory nerves are there? Lesser occipital, great auricular. And what is this? Transverse cervical. And what is this? Supraclavicular. So, these are the sensory nerves from which plexus is this? Cervical plexus. Is there any motor? Of course. Other than these sensory branches, remaining all are motor only. Except phrenic nerve. Phrenic nerve is mixed nerve. Clear? So, this is about cervical plexus. When you are studying about posterior triangle of neck, you must be observed lesser occipital, great auricular, transverse cervical and supraclavicular nerve. Right? Let me show you in the posterior triangle of neck. Imagine this is forehead. This is nose, lips. Somewhere here, there will be clavicle. This is a rough diagram. Here, mastoid process will be there. Is it or not? So, from sternum and clavicle to the mastoid process. What is this muscle? This muscle is sternocleidomastoid. Of course, here, your ear. At the junction of upper one third and lower two third of posterior border of sternocleidomastoid, point of nerves. Here, this is point of nerves. From this point of nerves, there will be emerging of these cutaneous nerves. What is this? Transverse cervical. See, this is transverse cervical, right? And what is this? Lesser occipital. Lesser occipital along the posterior border of sternocleidomastoid. Lesser occipital. Then great auricular. This is great auricular, right? It is not greater, it is great auricular, right? So it is great auricular. Clear? Then this is supraclavicular nerve. This is supraclavicular nerve. This is how sensory nerves are emerging out to supply head and neck. So that is about cervical plexus. That's it for this session.